Aussie singer and cabaret performer Jeff Duff has lived through some of the greatest music of all time. He's been part of the scene since the early 70s and still performs today. We sent Craig Bennett to learn more about this rock and roll legend.
The 70s and 80s gave birth to some of music's most wild and outrageous characters. Put on your red shoes and dance the blues. Blurring the lines between music and art, gender and sexuality. The UK had David Bowie, we have Jeff Duff. Well, Jeff Duff, this is an absolute thrill. I've got to say, what a career. Singer-songwriter, world-renowned, occasional actor. Do you pinch yourself sometimes thinking that's a pretty incredible career?
As a matter of fact, I don't. I just think all of those things are just what I do. I mean, I don't think I've had an extraordinary life at all. It just seems just very normal to me. I am
an anti-Christ. But the truth is, Jeff's life has been far from normal. He's been busted for wearing bawdy costumes, run for his life from London punks, and shared a journey with Ziggy Stardust himself.
Like me, he will make up every day of his life. I've always done that, and I always dress as if I'm performing on stage, even if I'm going shopping at the local supermarket.
Tell me about your association with David Bowie, because you obviously have shared a lot over the years, style, music prowess, etc. You got to know him, didn't you?
I first met David Bowie in London. I was doing a lot of really hip clubs over there, and one of the clubs was called the Embassy in Old Bond Street, a very exclusive club. Anyway, I was performing there one night, and the manager came out and said, David Bowie wants to meet you. He's in the dressing room. But he was not in a really good state the first time I met him. I think he was doing a lot of cocaine, you know, as he was through the 70s.
Then a surprise meeting in Sydney a decade later strengthened the bond.
I was walking down the street one day in Elizabeth Bay Road, and these English musicians came up to me and they said, "Hey, you're Duffo, do you want to come and say hello to Dave?" And I said, "Dave who?" And they said, "David Bowie, he's in the cafe there." I discovered that he'd been living next door to me in Elizabeth Bay.
What was the real David Bowie like? I mean, we know the public persona. You got to know the private man. What was he really like?
I don't think anybody got to know him that well. You know, I think he had this mystique about him. But I feel like we have lived parallel lives, you know, from art, you know, humble art school beginnings. I've just released my 30th album. When I'm performing the David Bowie show on set, I definitely don't try and impersonate. I just go on being me, because I've always dressed up. I've always worn makeup.
Jeff's career began in the 70s, fronting the band Kush, and he found himself in trouble from the very beginning. You don't even have to open his juicy new autobiography to see that.
The front cover is a photograph of me, of a costume that I made out of a rubber sex doll, and I was arrested in the costume in Ballarat in Victoria. It was a fancy dress ball, Your Honour. They came and took
me brain away. But it was his 10 years in London where that wild and crazy rock and roll lifestyle really caught up with Jeff, literally.
We ended up having to run for our lives. I ended up hiding in a telephone box and I thought, I'm not going to be able to get out of this alive. My record was called Give Me Back My Brain. Before the gig, I went out and bought a bucket of sheep's brains because I thought, I knew I was going to be attacked. So I started throwing the sheep's brains at the audience as they were gobbing at me and throwing cups and weapons at me.
Jeff was taking the UK by storm.
My publicist, Tony Bransby, was also Paul McCartney's publicist, Eurythmics, Queen, the Osmond Brothers.
Great pedigree there.
He looked after everybody.
So in demand was Duffo, the great Andy Warhol had this to say.
Sinatra, Presley, Jagger, Popeye and now Duffo.
Australia did not know what to do with you. Is that why you fled to London?
Yeah, I'd reached a bit of a stalemate here in Australia. I was fairly well known and accepted as far as the general media goes. It's just the industry had trouble with me.
Jeff was plastered across our screens throughout the 70s and 80s. He was a real favourite, especially in those outfits.
Is that why you were banned from Ray Martin's midday show?
Unfortunately, yes.
What happened?
I thought, right, I'm going to do Fever the way I want to do Fever, sort of a little androgynous. So I went into the studio and I did the camera check in normal clothes. My girlfriend at the time was a beautiful girl called Tawny, and she said, Are you going to wear those thigh-length boots and the leotard that are hanging in your dressing room? I had my own dressing room. And I said, of course. And what happened was Tawny sort of started embracing me and I got very excited. And it wasn't too late for it to go down. So I went on, they said, you're on. So I went running on stage and the cameras had to shoot above the waist. And I sang Fever, and afterwards, Ray Martin was, he was just a little annoyed because I didn't forewarn them that I was going to wear a leotard.
Well, this rock and roll life wouldn't be complete without a romp or two.
I was involved in a couple of orgies. Like, I was only young, I was only about 17 or 18. The enticement of an orgy appealed to me. And there was a knock on my door, and this girl said, Jeffrey, we've been watching you on stage. Would you like to come and have a bit of fun in room 14? I think I had my pyjamas on.
And just how does Jeff reflect on his whole career?
To be honest, I prefer to be doing my own material because I love my own original material. Occasionally, I throw in an original song of mine and I say, that was a rare David Bowie B-side. You probably haven't heard it before, but, you know, I'm premiering it tonight. Jack your hands.
Wasn't that a revealing story?
Yes.
Look, I actually did a charity function with Duffo about 2-3 weeks ago, and look, he's an amazing performer.
In a leotard?
Actually, he was in a white patent leather, skin tight, one piece jumpsuit.
How fabulous!
Fantastic.
Right, well, Jeff Duff's autobiography is called This Will Explain Everything, and it's out on May 30.